This is Janet Andrabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we will explain the elastic force and give its expression. Explain the elastic potential energy and give its expression. And finally, solve an example on elastic potential energy.
Restoring force, elastic force, or spring force. Consider figure A. We have a spring of natural length L0 and its free end coincides with O, the origin of the x-axis. In figure B, we stretch the spring horizontally to the right in the positive x direction. Now, while stretching the spring, we feel that something is resisting us. Actually, we feel the effect of the elastic force. So the elastic force is directed in the opposite direction, horizontally to the left. In figure C, we compress the spring horizontally to the left. The same thing happens. We feel that something is resisting us. We feel the effect of the elastic force, which is directed horizontally to the right in the opposite direction. So, the spring exerts a restoring force or elastic force towards point O in both figures. Why? In order to return to its natural length. Now, what is the expression of the elastic force? The expression is T is equal to minus KXI. Now, K is the force constant or spring constant, sometimes called the stiffness. And I is the unit vector along the x-axis. But what is x? X is the elongation or the compression of the spring. But also, x is an abscissa, so it is a position. Look at figure B. X is the position of the right end of the spring. The same thing happens in figure C. X is the position of the right end of the spring. Now let's go to the magnitude of the elastic force. The magnitude is a positive quantity, so we have T is equal to K times the absolute value of X. Let's talk about the units. The elastic force is expressed in Newton, in SI, and the abscissa in meter. So the unit of the force constant would be the unit of the force divided by the unit of the abscissa. So it is in Newton per meter.
Energy stored in a spring. First, let's watch this short video. The ball is pushed and compresses the spring. When the system is released, the spring ejects the ball with a speed V, so the ball possesses kinetic energy. The question now, from where does the ball gain its kinetic energy when ejected? The answer, while compressing the spring, the restoring force resists the motion of the ball, so its work results in transformation of the kinetic energy of the ball into a form of energy stored in the spring called elastic potential energy. Similarly, but in the opposite way, when the spring is released, the restoring force now helps or supports the motion of the ball. So its work results in transformation of the elastic potential energy that was stored in the spring into kinetic energy that gained by the ball.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, what is the expression of the stored energy or the elastic potential energy stored in a spring? When a spring is deformed means compressed or stretched by a distance x. So, the elastic potential energy stored in the spring is given by the formula 1/2 kx squared, where x is the variation in the length of the spring, where the spring is compressed or stretched by this displacement x. Since K is always positive and x squared is also always positive, then EPE is greater than or zero.
Now, let's solve an application about elastic potential energy. Consider the figure. A ball of mass 500 grams compresses a spring by a displacement of 10 centimeters. When the spring is released, it returns to its natural length and the ball is ejected with a speed of 1 meter per second. Neglect all friction. Now, take a look at the given. The mass of the ball is 500 grams. The speed of ejection is 1 meter per second and we neglect all friction. Question number one, calculate the kinetic energy of the ball at the instant of ejection. The formula of the kinetic energy is Ke is equal to 1/2 mv squared. Now, the mass of the ball is 500 grams, so we divide it by 1000, it becomes 0.5 kilogram. The speed is already expressed in SI units, so it is 1 meter per second, and the answer is 0.25 joule. The second question, deduce the maximum elastic potential energy that was stored in the spring. Now, in part one, we calculated the kinetic energy, the maximum kinetic energy that the ball possesses at the instant of ejection. Now, a question. From where does the ball gain this kinetic energy? Actually, after releasing the spring, the work done by the restoring force results in a transformation of the stored elastic potential energy into kinetic energy. Then EPE maximum is equal to Ke maximum, and it is equal to 0.25 joule. Now take into account that this result is not valid if we have friction, because if the ball is subjected to friction, then the friction would perform work, and this work would result in a transformation of part of the kinetic energy into thermal energy.
Number three, calculate the force constant of the spring. Force constant means K. We have to calculate K. Using the formula, EPE equal 1/2 KX squared. EPE is known and X is known. So K equal 2 EPE over X squared. Then substitute for EPE equal 0.25, X equal 0.1 meter, X equal 10 centimeter, but 10 centimeter is equivalent into 0.1 meter. You have to substitute the elastic potential energy in the joule and X in meter to get the SI unit of K, which is Newton per meter. So K equal 50 newtons per meter. Question number four, deduce the magnitude of the restoring force T. Magnitude means T without a vector. The magnitude is always positive. Take into consideration, the magnitude is always positive. And specify its direction when the spring is compressed by X equal 10 centimeters. We use this formula, the magnitude of the restoring force equal K times the absolute value of X. Why absolute value of X? X is an algebraic quantity. X could be negative or positive. The absolute value of X is always positive to get a positive value of the magnitude of the restoring force. Now, substitute for K equal 50 newtons per meter, X equal 0.1 meter, then T equal 5 newton. What about the direction of the tension? Or the restoring force. The restoring force is always directed towards the free end of the spring. Using this figure, the free end of the spring is O, and it is compressed by a displacement X, so the restoring force is directed towards O. From this figure, we can conclude that the restoring force is directed horizontally to the right.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.